If you want to reduce the crush of email in your inbox, send less email. It may sound somewhat overly simplistic, but it's highly effective. And it was a lesson I learned while at Yahoo. I worked with a number of people who were very intense users of email. They end up leaving the company, not in immediate succession, but close enough where I could see that it was having an impact on my inbox. And what essentially I came to learn was, because they sent email out quite a bit and I responded quite a bit, that would generate more emails, and round it would go. And when they left and I was sending out less email as a result, I was receiving a lot less email. There's some other tips too. We have a tendency, all of us, to use to synonymously with CC. And everyone on the to line thinks they should be in a position to respond. And every time someone responds, someone else feels the need to respond. It's also easy to overlook the importance of clarity and brevity in emails. And the longer and more complex an email, the more questions get raised. People are looking for follow-up answers, and you have to send more emails, and then more responses come back, and so forth and so on. So with a few areas of increased focus like that, you can definitely reduce the load.
So do you pick up the phone instead?
I use the phone. I use the phone in particular for people that are working outside of our Silicon Valley offices. Oftentimes, particularly in a volatile situation, people will send email. They're not always becoming a spectator to their own thoughts when they're authoring the email. And they'll send something out that may trigger someone on the receiving end. And you get a lot of vitriol going back and forth. And sometimes it's best to just say, let's take this offline, get together, and be able to provide additional context as to why people are upset or why there's friction. And you can resolve things much faster that way.
What is it about email? Things get lost in translation. People don't get tone.
I think it's exactly that. When you say people don't get tone, the vast, vast majority of human communication, certainly effective human communication, is subtextual. It's not necessarily the words. It's our body language and our voice inflection. And email, outside of emoticons, doesn't do a very good job of capturing that.